Hello everyone and welcome to another kit build review. This is a big rig that's not so big. It's in 1/32nd scale. It is a Revell USA release. It is the magnificent beast Chevy Bison. Check out that box art. Got the big old Bison back there. We got Big Sky Bison Jerky Company. We got the air dam on there, dual stacks, horns. It's a cool, cool model truck. It's a level 4, 1/32nd scale, so not as big as the 125th or 124th that you're used to. It still builds up to almost 10 inches long because it is a big rig. And it has 70 parts in the box, so we'll take a look at the stuff that's in there right now. Now, we're going to be doing something fun. Not only are we going to be building the model kit, but Revell has offered to my viewers to give away a kit just like this, this exact kit. Watch me build it, then win it, and have it shipped to your door. The really only limitation on this is we're gonna have three rules that you have to follow that I'm gonna talk about in the video later and let you know what those rules are. And the contest is open to Revell fans, fans of the channel in the United States and Canada. That includes Alaska, Hawaii, and Canada. You can enter the contest. If you're overseas, I'm sorry, the shipping is just so expensive that it won't be able to be sent, plus taxes and VAT and all that stuff. So let's take a look at the parts in the box and we will start building our model kit. This is a press together kit. It is, you know, a snap fit style kit. So we're gonna have some details omitted. It doesn't have a full engine. It's got a nice engine molded in the bottom. Of course, that never bothers me. Curb style kits don't bug me at all. We've got that nice frame there. We've even got details for the fifth wheel for the air brakes on there. We can paint and detail that up. You saw my review of the Mack truck in this scale and it came out looking just beautiful. We've got our differentials here joined together with the suspension. We got large wheel studs. I always like that. We've got our front fenders as separate pieces. And then we've got our battery box on the side as its own two pieces, or battery or toolbox. The interior is one large piece. We've got our dashboard molded in. We will need to attach our shifter and our steering wheel, but the seats are molded in. We've got that cool air dam for the roof. Those just look so neat on those trucks. We've got our front axle. We've got our air filter, our air tank. We've got some small frame pieces here. We got some hose and connectors. We've got our rear fenders. You can see those in case you're curious what those are. They're right there. They're usually a metallic tone and we can fix that right up with some spray paint. We're not gonna have a problem. On the last white parts tree where there's actual individual parts, we've got our drive shaft. We've got what looks like our air tank, our air cleaner. Got some pieces here and I'm not even sure what those are. We'll find out. We've got our fifth wheel with the release lever and everything on it. We've got a black parts tree. We got one little tire hanging off kind of loose, so we'll get that up close so you can see it. It does have, it says, I can't even read the name on that. It's real small, I have to get my glasses out. But it does, oh, it's a Union. Never mind, Union tire. Tread pattern on there, and then these will snap into the wheels so we can get those painted. We got our steering wheel right there, we've got our shifter right there, and we've got our mud flaps with full frame on both sides. So those will press into place when we're all done. We've got all 10 tires, and then we've got the cab with sleeper. We've got all the door engraving, door handles. We'll have to use a little chrome marker or silver marker on those. We got our trim work. All of our inserts for the air dam, for the mirrors, for the marker lights, all done for us, for the antennas, for the smokestacks, for the air tanks. Even makes it look like the hood folds forward. It's a pretty cool detail. And it's a nice size. Even though it's 1/32nd scale, it is a nice size kit. I'm going to switch sides of the table. We've got our clear parts tree here. We've got our window glass, which will be divided by the cab, and then we've got our windshield wipers molded in, and they are a good size relief, so we should be able to get a marker on those. Then we've got the little sight window in the passenger door. We've got two chrome trees. So look at this one first. We got our smokestacks. We've got our front bumper. with all the little license plate cutouts and the marker lights. Don't knock those lights off unless you want to trim them off for a cleaner look. We got that sweet Chevy grill. Get a lot of black paint or black wash in there. Will look much, much nicer than just chrome. And be careful of your hood ornament. On the second tree, we've got our dual tanks. We've got our beautiful set of wheels on there. Our mirrors and antennas are one piece. Again, be careful. Our air horns, our marker lights are spread out across the tree. You really can just leave them chrome and use a marker to make the ambers on there. We got the cap to our air cleaner, and we've got our lead up to our smokestacks right there. Headlights are there in case you're wondering why you didn't see them on the clear parts tree. What else we got in the box? We've got a stupendous set of decal options. You can build the exact box art. You can see how they go around the back and fold down. Help you mask, because then that will cover it up. We've got those in blue shades and in red and brown shades. We've also got these nice yellow and red markers on there. Full set of dash decals, which on this kit's going to be a big help to get those in there, with their wood grain and everything. Got those license plates on the front bumper, all in one sheet. So I like seeing that. Should be able to get those on there. And we got the big sky logos for the air dam. And that, we've got some white Chevy logos. We've got DOT logos in white, though they're hard to see. And we've got diesel only for the tanks and extinguisher. We've got all the needed decals to make this thing look pretty sweet, including the wee Bison decals for the hood over the stripes. Now you can go ahead and paint it any way you want. I'm going to start building mine, and we'll be back in a second.
Thank you.
Assembly goes extremely easy. It's a press fit kit. There's not going to be any challenges. I've assembled as much as I want to get to the point where I will then start painting the kit. So we got our fifth wheel on. We've got our rear suspension on. The kit really doesn't require glue. You don't have to use it. I do just so when I'm grabbing things and moving them around, they don't fall off. Now, the front suspension will go on later, and I will be able to attach that easily. It is just going to fit right into place where we need it to be, but I want to be able to paint that engine and the filters on the side and the transmission. And with the front suspension, you could get in there and you could do it, but it's not going to be nearly as easy. But the rear suspension and the fifth wheel will all match the frame in the paint scheme that I'm going to go with. So I did attach those because there's nothing underneath there that I need to get to worry about. I've got the fuel tanks assembled. They're chrome. Didn't use any glue because I didn't want to muss anything up, and they look just nice as they are. They got some seams in them. I suppose you could sand those down and repaint it, but that's not my style of modeling. I just want to have a good time putting together cool models. We've got the smokestacks here with their little caps. That's what those are. Don't cut those off. Those are caps for the exhaust. You can see them up here as the truck's riding down the street with their counterweights on them. They press together, they are smooth stacks. They don't have heat shields on them. Those are ready to go on the truck when we're all done. I'm gonna leave those chrome. The wheels, I'm not going to leave a super chrome. I like the more subdued look to them than that bright, bright chrome. Even though, you know, a dressed up truck like this could have chrome wheels, it's up to how you want to build your model. But I will be flat coating those and black washing them to subdue them. We got our mud flaps, we've got our air tank, our air cleaner. I did need to clamp the top together. I glued it, clamped the top together. The seam was a little bit bigger than I'd want it to be. Now it's absolutely fine. We can get a paint job on that. The battery box, I did assemble off the kit. The battery box, I'm going to paint the black color. But like they have it on the box art, I do like the box art on this one, the top step and the bottom step are a metallic tone. So I want to get in here and paint this runner and paint the step, and it's going to be easier to do that if I leave it off the truck, spray it outside the truck, and then detail it by hand. Front suspension, these are your mud flaps. They are keyed in a specific way. You cannot put them on the wrong way, so don't worry about that after you get them painted. The drive shaft I want to do in a metallic tone for the back of the truck. The interior, obviously, I want to paint separately and then install into the truck. The front fenders are going to be the lower body color, and they're separate. And by leaving them off and painting them, for one, we're never going to see where it's attached on those rails. So I can get that painted by itself. We got the cab and the sleeper here. We got the spoiler, which I can just grab onto where it clips in and get that painted as well. And then I can mask the cab on the hood line right along there without having the fenders or anything in the way. So I can get my top body color on, and then I can run my mask all the way down and around and and back, and I won't have to fight with anything with the mask. It'll make it a lot easier. So that's it. I've got the tire package over here. Those all snap in later, so I will get those painted a flat black color so that they look better than black plastic, and that will be it. The other chrome items, the grill, the bumper, the grab handles, the mirrors, the lid to the air cleaner, the headlights, those I'm just going to leave chrome. I think I would have those chrome in real life. So I'm going to get all this stuff over to paint. We're going to mask the body. We're going to have some fun, and I'll do that right now. Now that you've sat through all of this, Let's talk about how to win this kit, okay? How to win the Bison is extremely simple and it doesn't cost you a penny. If you want to win this kit absolutely free at no charge to you, sent from Revell, not from me, Revell USA is cool enough that they're going to send it to you directly. What you need to do is a few things. One, you need to have a working contact email on YouTube, because when you win, I will not put in the comment section, "Hey, you won, send me a message." Don't fall for that stuff. Those are scammers. I will contact you directly through your email that you have on YouTube. So if you don't have a YouTube contact email, or it's a dead email, or it doesn't work anymore, there's no way you could win the kit. So if you live in the United States or in Canada, what you need to do to win the kit is, one, like the HPI Guys Workshop page on Facebook. I will link in the description of that. Two, like the Revell USA Facebook page, Revell USA. The regular Revell you can like too. Revell USA on Facebook. I will link to that in the description. You need to like both of those. You need to comment in the comment section of this video your favorite movie or TV show big rig. It doesn't have to be a Bison. It could be any rig at all. My favorite movie or TV rig is most certainly the original Smokey and the Bandit. Even Smokey and the Bandit 2. I like both rigs with the cowboy trailer on the back. But that's my favorite. Put in that there your favorite movie rig. You can also put in what you'd like to do with this truck, the paint scheme you'd like to put. That's all optional. But you have to put in that video, in that comment section, your favorite movie or television big rig. It could be from Duel. It could be the truck from Knight Rider, Smokey and the Bandit, Moving On, BJ and the Bear. Whatever you like, there's no judgment. There's no right or wrong answer in this thing. I just need it so that I can have the computer program pick a winner at random, contact them via their YouTube email address, and then I will get your street address from you. I will provide that to Revell USA, and they will mail out one of these kits to the lucky winner. So, thanks for playing the game. Thanks for watching the video to this point. Wanted to make sure it wasn't just the looky-loos. It's actually the actual subscribers and people that actually watch these videos would see that part of the video and get a chance to win a kit. I wish you all good luck. When we come back, I'll be doing the painting and the detailing. the super easy, relaxing, fun Chevy Bison build continues. Don't forget to enter into the contest with the directions I gave you earlier on how to do so. We have got all this stuff ready to go together. The reason I don't have the rest of all the cool chrome stuff put on the truck is because I need to add the decals along that stripe, and I need to attach it to the chassis. And I'm afraid, like, if I put things like the nice thin air horns on the roof, when I'm pressing it into place, I will break it. I've got the airfoil. I've got the marker lights installed because I really can't break those. They're sturdy parts, and these are small parts on the top. So those I don't have to worry about. Got the windshield in. The grill does not attach till later, but I've got the fenders snapped in, and I've got those headlights with a little bit of Mod Podge attached to those, and that cab is ready to go. You can see the glass presses in, and the little piece of side glass presses right into the door, so you shouldn't have problems with that. The mud flaps will also go on the back of the chassis once the body is all on, because if I'm moving that around, on the Mac, I broke off one of these thin pins, and I don't want to do it again because then I had to hold it in place when I glued it. The grill goes on as one of the last steps of the assembly. Once the actual truck is on the chassis, then we put the grill in. That's what the instructions say. And that looks real nice. I got the gold bow tie, we got the red hood ornament, and we got the blacked out grill. The front bumper will then go on to the chassis. I will put the air tanks and the compressor tanks and all that stuff. I'll put the air filter and all that. When the decals are done, it makes no sense to put the smokestacks and everything on the truck when I've got to get underneath to get those stripes all the way around. So those will go on after the decals are on and in place. And then all that's left on the chrome tree is the two rear handles behind the sleeper and the beautiful one-piece mirror and CB antenna. That assembly on each side, which looks great because I've seen it on the Mac. The interior looks nice. I just did a very rough hand painting. It's hard to get a straight line inside the cab, but I did the door panels and the seat, left the carpet black, left the steering wheel black. We can actually move the steering wheel still. It just presses into place. And the dash decals go a million miles to make that look nice in there inside the truck. I really enjoy it. The chassis itself, everything presses together without a fight at all. We've got our drive shaft, transmission, engine. I just copied the box art. So the box art underneath with those colors, I wasn't too worried about it. Didn't even check the colors in the manual. Just copied the box art build. Got our mud flaps pressed in. Got our fuel tanks on. Got our side steps and our battery box on. It is looking good. It looks more than adequate enough for a 1/32nd scale. So I'm going to do those final assemblies, put on those decals, and when I come back, we'll have her on the turntable. Hello and welcome back for the final of Revell USA's Chevy Bison in 1/32nd scale. This kit should be available right now from folks like Model Roundup. I will link to modelroundup.com in the description. I want to thank my man over at Revell USA for sending this over. He let me know it was on the way, and I can't be more excited about it. I figured if it built half as good as the Mac 1/32nd scale, I was gonna have a good time, and I did. It builds up just as easy. One tiny issue as it comes around, you see these long pins that hold the body onto the chassis? One of mine snapped off. It was super brittle, came off real easy. Doesn't matter, because you could even cut those off and the body would still sit on the frame. But I just wanted to let you know that it did snap off, so go kind of easy putting those on the back when you snap the body onto the frame. Otherwise, the kit builds up so nice and is really begging for some paint. You could have this kit built by a total newbie, leave it in the white paint scheme, and then build it from there and put the stripes on it and stuff. But doing paint to it really, really adds to this press fit kit. Those decals went on so nice. Look how they bend around. They all line up right on that paint line, and they folded right around the body without issue. They sink in. They're behind the air cleaner and the air tanks and all this kind of stuff, and everything just looks great. Yes, it's a press fit kit, but come on. That's a cool looking Chevy Bison. I mean, that is a really nice looking truck. And 1/32nd scale means it's an easy, extra, super duper easy 2-day build for anyone. Anyone can build this kit. Whether it's a total noob, whether it's someone who likes tractor trailers and can paint their models, a couple cans of cheap spray paint from the hardware store, some Rust-Oleum, some Krylons, and you could have a model that looks pretty darn awesome. You'd want some black, and then you'd want whatever your body colors are going to be to complement. You know, you've got the browns that I used, you've got the blue, or you've got the yellow and red scheme. So you've got three different options on there for striping, which gives you a ton of color paint. You know, if you bought two colors, if you bought black and you bought silver, that silver would look so sweet with either one of these stripe schemes on the whole body. Especially the blue would really look nice. But I love the details. I hope that Revell has a gajillion more of these 1/32nd scale semis. I know they have a cab over in their catalog. I'd love to see that cab over. I get really excited when I see these now, and I didn't think much of them when they sent me the Mac. I was like, oh no. Now that I've built them, I'll build 100 of them. I don't care. As many of these 1/32nd scale rigs as they have, I love them. They look awesome. They display awesome, and I really enjoy it. So again, thanks to Revell USA for sending this over. Make sure to enter the contest. This kit is so fine. It's so much fun. And you, the winner, will receive this exact copy, this boxing of the kit with those cool decals and all the cool parts. So make sure you enter. I gave an idea of how to enter the kit in this video. By paying attention to the video, you will find out exactly how to enter. It's super easy and it's free to you, and there will be no shipping costs to you, no special scams. We don't need your credit card number. I will contact you via your YouTube email and let you know you've won and get your address from you to give to Revell USA, and they will send you the model kit. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. I appreciate all your views, all your kind comments and suggestions, and I will see all of you at the next review.